Hi everyone, this is Aki with another quick video on pages, and this is in response to a comment that I've received on one of my videos about adjusting margins in pages. So I got a comment from Manuel, which I thank you very much, Manuel, for this comment, said that how do I set different margins within the same document? For example, I have a cover letter and resume both on the same document, cover letter on page one, resume on page two. I want to keep the 1-inch margins for my cover letter, but want to reduce the margin size for my resume. I've tried to create a new section, but when I adjust the size of the margins for my resume, it makes the changes to the entire document. And so I, you know, was really interested in this. So I have an example that I put together, and I was trying to solve this problem for Manuel. So I have a, you know, document here, a dummy example document in pages, and I have three sections, and I label them section 1, 2, 3. And this kind of shows what Manuel is experiencing. So basically, you know, we have section 1 and they're all separated because you can see that when I click on the thumbnail on the left, it highlights whichever section it is. So let's say I'm section 1 and I see if I go to the menu at the top document, you click the document right there and you scroll down, you can see the document's margins are 1 inch throughout left, right, top and bottom. And then when I looked at the section 2, you have to click into your section to see what's the situation in that section. So now I'm in section 1 and 2 and 3, and I can see all of them are 1 inch. So let's say in section 1, like Manuel, I want to keep it 1 inch. And then in section 2, I want to change it to increase the margin for left and increase the margin for right. And if I go to this section, I can see that it did that. And I can see it at the very top. I have a ruler and it shows me the length of each page, which is 7 inches. And then the height is 10, and I can see right now that these little triangles at the top show me basically the margins, so I can see that it's 1.5 and 1.5. But if I go back to section 1, it also changed, so, and then in section 3. So you see, that's the problem that Manuel is experiencing. So like, how do you fix it? So basically, once you have the margins, it seems like it's adjusting everywhere. So okay, let me close out of this document and I'll show you two different ways to solve this. So first, like, let me just mention that pages, you can set it up as a word processing document, kind of like, you know, when you think about Microsoft Word, which is basically like you're typing different documents, letters, and you're using it as using a lot of text. You can also use it as page layout, which is kind of like when you think about it, maybe designing a PDFs, or like if you used InDesign software, maybe flyers or something that won't change format. So let me go first over if you're using your document as word processing, and you can set up your, you know, resume and cover letter or whatever document you have in both ways, but I'll show you how you can solve the situation when you want a different section or page to have different margins. So here we're going to use the word processing way. So the way to check that you're using the word processing setup is if you go to document on the right and you scroll down, you have to have the document body checked. So that means that you're using it as a word processing section. So you see that we have margins right now, left 1 inch, right 1 inch, top and bottom 1 inch. And when I go to section 2, I also have that situation. To go around, let's say if I want to set up things within different margin, I can do a couple of things. One way is to create text boxes. So your text, whatever you have, you could, you know, size it in text boxes and change how, you know, how wide they are. So like, you know, this, the way to do that, basically you click somewhere on that section and you say text box, and then you type, you know, the text. So I'm going to just space it right there, and you can, you know, design the size of this text box however you like. So make it narrow, So you can control the way you set up your text this way through text boxes, but there's a lot of manual, and you can see also that things that are like shapes or images actually can be outside your margin. So even though my margin is still showing up left one and right 1 inch, I can put things outside of it. And the same with text boxes, they can actually go outside your original margin. So it could be, you know, you could set up maybe 1 inch on here, or make the narrow margins throughout the whole document, and then put your text boxes and make it either longer or narrower, like whichever way, but you have some control here. Then a second way to do it is basically here I have section 3, and the way I was able to set up in more narrow, that you notice the margin is still the same, but the way to make it more narrow is you select the text in your section and you go to format, layout, and you use the indents. And so this would, you know, change the indents. So you see right now, this would be what I have in section 1. But in a way to make it more narrow, I can select the text and I say the first line of each paragraph and all the lines actually on the left should be, you know, move to the left, maybe 25 more, 1/4 of an inch. And then the same on the right, I want to move it half an inch. So this is a way, so you can see the section 1 is this width, and then section 3 is this width. So these are like two ways to go about it if you're using the word processing layout in Pages. Now, let's say if you're going to use the page layout, I know it's confusing because we say page layout in for Pages, but that's the name that Pages and Apple decided to use. So here I have 3 sections, and now everything in my documents here is laid out in text boxes. So the way to check that you're using the page layout formatting is if you click on your document at the top and then you scroll down, you have to make sure it's not checked, the document body is not checked. So that means all your setup is actually in text boxes. Now, you can always convert your document from word processing to page layout, but if, let me show you, if you have everything as word processing document set up, and I uncheck this, it will ask you to convert it. And if you convert it, if you don't have your text in text boxes, you lose everything. You see, everything is gone. So I'm just going to undo it. So, okay, let me go back to the page layout. Okay, so the page layout document, everything, if you see, if I click on everything, I can see these are text boxes. Everything is in text boxes. So this gives you a control of how you want to lay things out. And in page layout, you have this option to actually not only see the ruler, the way to see the ruler, if you go to view, you have view or hide ruler. So I'm viewing it right now, so I have the option to hide it, but I'm just going to keep it this way. And then you also have the way, an option to see guides. So guides are the ones that you can use to kind of control the margins maybe per different sections. So the way to set up margin is if you just click on the ruler on the left and you can drag it. And you see at the very top, I can see where I want to put my guides to kind of line up my documents. So you can change it. So I had it right here. Now, if you want to remove something, you just drag it off the document and it just makes this animation of like deletion. And the same from the top, you can just set up this way and put it somewhere. And then if you want to change your mind, you get rid of it. So you see like this section I set up for 1 inch everywhere, and then section 2 I set up so very narrow, like I set it up at 1/4 of an inch on left and right. So you can set up however you like. And then my section 3, I put the guides 1.5 inch on each side, and then I just lined up everything this way. So hopefully this video helped you, you know, figure it out how to adjust your margins if you have different sections and you want to have different width if you're using word processing or page layout in Pages. So thanks so much for watching.